It's in the Library of Congress. The book is called Tomorrow's Energy Need Not Be Fuel. And in that book, he gave reference to what I'm talking about, that that of levitation, that the bumblebee, when he starts to beat his wings, when he starts to flap his wings, there's a little cavity, a hollow cavity next to the larynx inside his system that's hollow. And when he beats his wings, he starts to resonate this energy, and it goes back and forth, just similar to a guitar strumming on one side of the room and hitting the same chord on the other side of the room, or somebody hitting a high C and breaking a crystal. It's the same thing. It's resonance. And he said, what they do, they resonate. And when they resonate, they eventually reach the resonance of the field around them. And he explained it this way to me, that the earth was, of course, spinning, but it was operating on a frequency of 8.5 hertz per second or so forth. And he says, once this bumblebee hits that resonant frequency of its surroundings, it becomes a free agent. It creates a magnetic bubble around itself, and it can go anywhere it wants. And I said, well, that's not in any of the science books. He said, I know. You probably never see it there either, but that's what happens. They'll discover it someday and bring it out, but it's just we have a conventional way of doing things, and then we have a natural way of doing things, and they're totally different. They're diametrically opposed in many, many cases.